I used to live in New York City, and every day I'd take the subway to work. And New York City's kind of like that, as a grid, just like this in most of the city. And I would come up here, and I'd have to walk 3 blocks north and 5 blocks east to get to work. And usually I would go as fast a route as possible. So I would always cover 8 blocks. But as you can see, there are lots of ways I could have done that. Could have gone up here, 1 block north, hot dog stand here, over to here, good egg sandwiches, up here, another hot dog stand there, and then I went into work. Or I could have started here and gone this way, and really nice Indian food there. And straight 3 blocks north, there's this Thai place, fantastic here. And then turn east and head on into work. There are lots of ways I can do that. As you can see, I didn't need a map because, like most guys, I navigate by gut. But when I was on the subway, usually I'd want to plan out my route. I'd sit down and write down my route because, well, you know, when I'm walking through the city, I don't want to be thinking about which block am I going to turn on. I want to be looking around, looking at all the neat stuff going on, look for new restaurants. So usually when I was on the subway, I'd write my route down. And I was kind of curious one day, how many different routes could I follow? So this is usually how I'd write my route down. First, I knew I was going to take 8 steps. So I'd write 8 blanks for my steps. And then I just write down N's and E's for north and east to plan out my route. For example, here's one route I might take. Might go north first, east a couple times, north again, east a couple times more, north and then east. So go ahead and draw that up here. North to east, one more north, a couple more east, one more north and then east into work. So there's one. And here's another one. Draw this one in red. Maybe I can start off going 3 east, 1 north, a couple more east, and then a couple more north. So I know I need 3 norths and 5 easts, so I'll be putting 3 N's and 5 E's in here. Let's go ahead and draw that one. 3 blocks east, 1 north, 2 east, 2 north. So those are two of the paths. Now looking at this, I could figure out, hey, now I can see how to count them. I know I have to take 8 steps. Now, I'm going to have to pick 3 of them to be north. Now, at first, I might think that's 8 times 7 times 6. Because I could pick this one to be north, and this one to be north, and this one to be north. But then I realize, wait a second, it doesn't matter what order I choose these 3 to be north in these steps. So what I really have here is a combination. I want 8 choose 3. 8 choose 3 ways to do this because, well, if I'm going to pick these 3 to be north, it doesn't matter what order I pick those 3. I can pick this one, then this one, then this one. Or I could have chosen this one to be north first, then this one. So the order doesn't matter. I have 8 slots here. I have to choose 3 of them to be north. So there are 8 choose 3 ways for me to pick 3 of my 8 steps to be north. And I know how to compute that. That's pretty easy. 8 times 7 times 6 over the 3 factorial for the 3. 3 times 2 times 1. 3 and 2 makes 6. 56 ways for me to get to work. But you know, some days I'd be going in and I'd know I have a rough day ahead. Those days I might want to take a little extra time to get to work. So I'd mix things up a little bit and I'd throw in 1 step to the west in my route. So I might come out of the subway and go west immediately. So basically I added on. I might add one on out here. Or I might add it on in between. You know, I go over, up, back one, up, and then on to work. Or I might come all the way over here, go up, back to work. So if I want to change these paths, you know, maybe I race this and I go west first, then up, then over. And let's see, what might we have done here? Instead of that, we go out, up, and back. So you see each of these has 1 step west in them. Now if we're going to take 1 step west, that means we need to throw in an extra step east too, to make up for that 1 step west. So now I know I'm taking a 10-step path. So when I'm riding the subway in, I sit there and I need to lay out 10 steps as my plan. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And of course, we're going to count how many different paths I could take. So the first thing I would do, I'd look at that and be, okay, I got 10 choices. I'm going to choose the west step first. Oh, let's see, I pick this one. And there are 10 ways I can do that. So I have 10 ways to choose the west step. So we start with our 10. Now what? Well, I have 9 steps left. And I have to choose 3 of them to be north. And just as before, it doesn't matter what order I choose 3 of these blanks to be north. I just have to choose 3 different ones. You know, say I choose this one, this one, and this one. Then the rest have to be east. So I see that of those 9 blanks I had left, I have to choose 3 to be north. So for any place that I choose the west, so for any of these 10 choices of where we're going to put that step west, I'm going to have 9 choose 3 ways to put in the ends, and then all the rest are just E's. So now we can just figure this out. 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 divided by 3 times 2 times 1. Now before we compute this, you might think, well, can we check our answer here? Is there another way to do this problem? And we see eeny weeny up here, and we think, hey, we can use eeny weeny. Because no matter how we order these letters, that gives us one of these paths. So really, in order to count the number of paths we have here, all we're doing is counting the number of different words we can make when we rearrange the letters in eeny weeny. And we know how to do this problem already. We know how to count the number of ways we can order the letters in eeny weeny. There are 10 letters in eeny weeny. And then we have to divide by 3 factorial for the ends. And then we have to divide by 6 factorial for the e's. Now at first, you might think, wait a second, these answers look different. But when we write 10 factorial as 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 factorial, we see our answers are the same. Because the 6 factorials here, they cancel. And these two numbers are the same. And then we can just sit there and we can do the arithmetic now. 3 cancels with 9 leaves 3, 2 cancels with 8 leaves 4, 3 times 4 is 12, times 7, that's 84, times 10 is 840. So we see that we have 840 ways. Once we just throw in that one west, makes us choose the extra east as well. Now we have 840 ways to get from the subway all the way up to work. Now, we could check our answer again by sitting there and drawing out all 840. So we get out maps, we make 840 pictures of our routes, but instead, it's great. We used eeny weeny to check our answer instead of drawing those 840 pictures. So we see that eeny weeny is one word that's worth almost 1,000 pictures.